been planning and saving for this trip for a few years now. Basically, me and my mate James are going to quit our jobs. We're going to travel around the world for 9 months. And yeah, we're going to start in Hong Kong and travel through 20 different countries across 4 continents and finish in New York.
We're in the Caribbean, so rum's included with our lunch.
And we're going to take just one camera and film everything.
Well, this is not a bad place to spend the day. Crossing the border from Panama to Costa Rica.
Continuing your tradition of trying to pick up animals. Stop being so brave. Run away. There we go.
Well, we made it here. The climax being Sunday Funday Pool Crawl.
What madness are you going to try and attempt now?
Maybe a front flip into a dive.
We're now 7 months into our 9 month round the world trip. We spent the first 3 months working our way through Southeast Asia, 6 weeks in Australia, a month in New Zealand before arriving in South America, where we've just finished a 2 week adventure in Peru, walking the Inca Trail to Machu Picchu.
Probably gonna be the most physically demanding thing we do.
Super ready to start this beautiful trip.
Finished with it to the top.
Done, mate.
Food here is amazing. We're so well looked after by the porters.
One of the best captain speeches ever.
Welcome to Machu Picchu, the last spiritual refuge of the Incas.
Following this, we headed deep into the Amazon jungle, where our time unfortunately got cut short.
Time for a night tour through the Amazon.
You looking at me?
I'm so scared right now.
Can you see it eating?
Yeah. We're going to try and pick it up.
I'm wondering why you have this fascination on picking things up.
Right, mate?
Now, we're heading for the penultimate leg of our trip with 3 final weeks of beaches and jungles in Central America. We had a couple of nights in Panama City, where we explored around the town and made the obligatory visit to the Panama Canal. The canal is 48 miles long and connects the Pacific Ocean with the Atlantic Ocean via the Caribbean Sea. The French originally spent 13 years constructing it, but it was completed by the Americans, who took control of the territory in 1903 and finished the canal by 1914.
Missed a ship going through by 3 minutes. Never mind.
James thrilled by the canal.
We're heading to the San Blas Island, which at the start of the trip, when we're back at Heathrow, I said this is one of the things I'm looking forward to, one of the moments.
One of like the little Caribbean islands, yeah. Like Pirates of the Caribbean style, like the size of this place. Hopefully Keira Knightley will be there as well.
It's going to be amazing. However, we have to leave at 5 in the morning, and we didn't get back from the night out until 4, so we're actually still drunk, and then we're about to get on a 3-hour bus and a 2-hour boat journey, so it's going to be fun.
A group of us squeeze into a 4x4 Jeep and travel to the opposite side of Panama to the Caribbean coast.
Play us a tune.
It was a deck.
Once we boarded the boat, we had a short journey downstream before we reached the sea, and we're soon surrounded by the tiny San Blas Islands.
Well, this is not a bad place to spend the day. A tiny little island in the Caribbean. But yeah, we're just gonna hang out. Drink plenty of beer, do some beach volleyball, whatever you want really. It's a tough life. We're in the Caribbean, so rum's included with our lunch.
So James can have more rum with his rum. That smile on your face, biggest smile I've seen all day.
Some fishermen sold us some fresh shrimp straight out of the water to have for dinner that evening.
What's for dinner?
Pero no lo agarran así con la mano, no. Sí, con un palo, sí, en la punta, una argolla. Sí, la
Hey, Simpsons. It's a video, not a still thing. So yeah. You have to talk or do something, you know.
You have to lick it.
This is our lunch tonight. Dinner.
Take two, take two.
This is our dinner tonight.
Wow, it's perfect.
Trippy.
He's getting away.
You only want the peanuts.
Excuse me, which bit is the penis on the shrimp?
That's the bit you just
cut off.
So he has two penises. Penises, right? How do you say the plural?
I don't know. I've only got one.
It's
I've never
English.
Thought.
It's your fucking language. It's the only language you know. So how? What is the plural of penis?
Come on. Penises. Penis.
Cocks.
Yeah, dicks.
We are going to brave the storm to get to the next island. James and Sarah did their sun dance to make the storm stop. It didn't work. Everybody ready to brave the storm?
No.
Oh, please.
Aha, see.
Don't eat that. Come on.
Now I'm
completely.
Stop us
now. Now we're completely dry.
The island we were staying on is a village for the indigenous Kunas, and we were sleeping in hammocks inside their school.
Dinner's ready.
Dinner's ready.
Okay. Woohoo! You ready for dinner?
Yeah.
Shrimpy, you've changed your look.
Yeah, kind of.
Such good memories together.
In the morning, we had a tour of the Kuna village. There are 49 different communities in the San Blas Islands, and each has their own political organization. Their economy is based on agriculture, fishing, and the manufacture of clothing.
Taking a banana skirt.
I want one
After the tour, we headed off to chill out on a couple more islands. In the first one, we had ourselves a barbecue, and James, after 7 months of trying, finally managed to climb a palm tree.
Wow.
That's about the photo. Failed in Laos, but succeeded in wherever this place is.
Panama.
From here, we stopped off at the starfish pool, which was a shallow pool-like area full of starfish.
Yeah, starfish, starfish. Nice.
So you know the album, Chocolate Covered Starfish, but you didn't know that's what it meant.
I don't know it.
Limp Bizkit.
Don't know what chocolate starfish is.
No. I do know.
Come on, you can do it.
Oh! Starfish!
Help. Give him some moral support. You see the person who's spot.
No!
Oh,
wait! Oh, that's so cruel! Oh, what a weird twist of fate!
He was there, he had it.
James saving starfish.
Yeah, well done, you. Useless.
Our final stop was Franklin Beach, where we'll spend the rest of our time chilling out on this small Caribbean island.
This is where we're staying tonight. Got a Barbie doll guard looking after our cabin. Girls just chilling. You alright?
Yeah, man.
Yeah, man. Brilliant. We got volleyball, basketball, dining area, and a bar. Should be right for one night.
There's a bird stealing our crisps.
There he goes. Was it? Just walks in, takes one crisp, flies out. Little fucker.
Have to capture him. Barbecue him.
None of the birds dare go in our room because we got fucking Barbie.
Shush.
Barbie protecting us.
Franklin Beach rivaled Dondette in Laos as one of the most chilled out places we've ever been. And just like Dondette, we were quite content just relaxing, hanging out, and doing pretty much nothing. Which was great for us, but obviously, doing nothing doesn't exactly make exciting video. So after nearly two full days on the island, we were heading back to the mainland.
I'm on the boat back, it's all lovely and dry, safe and warm. Well, we're nearly there. You're dry.
Oh, I'm perfectly dry. Got like a nice blow dry ready from the wind.
You dry?
Yeah.
Yeah. James?
<He's> dry.
You're so wet trees. Like a snail.
After making our way back to Panama City, we caught an overnight cross-country bus to Bocas del Toro, collection of small islands right on the Caribbean coast.
Right, we're at Bocas del Toro, which is a bit of a party town in the Caribbean, and we're at a party hostel.
From our hostel, we did a day boat tour around the islands, which began with spotting some dolphins.
We're trying to find some dolphins. Luckily, we're the only boat out here, so.
The tour continued to a good spot for snorkeling, as long as we dodged the jellyfish.
Fish like Ritz then.
And finally, on the way to a beach, we saw a sloth up in the trees. But really, most of our time in Bocas was spent, and get this for a segue, lazing around like a sloth. We just chilled out at our aqua lounge hostel, trying stupid acrobatics into the water.
It wasn't too bad.
Now, James had a little accident with us the other night.
Wow. Yeah. I just dived in. It's a good dive. But I just scratched my leg on this race on my way back home.
Shit. This is James's dive. I'll get from here first. You have a few goes. Good form. I'll give it a 3. How'd you rate that, guys?
6.
6? Alright, I gave it a 3.
7 for me.
7?
7.
3.5. Gonna try and do what?
Front flip.
Yeah, why not? James is going for the front flip. This could go terribly wrong. That'll be funny for us. What madness are you going to try and attempt now?
Maybe a front flip into a dive?
This will be good.
It's not going to happen.
See the fear in his eyes.
What do I need to do? Like, get higher? Rotate faster? What? Both?
Everything. Just do it like that, but, like, correctly. Oh, he's getting better for sure.
That would do. That would definitely do.
Oh. Thank you for watching this all afternoon. Can James master this before the sun sets? She's disappointed.
I'll let you down. Kind of did a fit.
Not a cool one.
Well.
Well.
I could do my Jesus dive. You know, it's like take
Do it.
Yeah?
Do it.
JC dive.
Yeah.
I'll probably end up voting him.
Yeah. All right. I see something spiritual here, something holy.
Oh gosh, I'm so nervous. I could see the pain in your eyes and everything. It was
the
really
sacrifice.
Awesome. Yeah. Oh my gosh.
JC.
That was a good one.
By that one?
Yeah.
There you go. What can I say?
Jesus Christ, ladies and gentlemen.
I was moved by that. That was just, I felt Jesus in my heart there. And I think I'm going to buy a Coke, so.
From Bocas, it was just a short journey to the Costa Rican border.
We are crossing the border from Panama to Costa Rica, and it's the usual border bullshit, and that the first window says you have to pay $3 to leave. The second window says if you get charged for leaving, it's against the law, please report it. So, same bullshit, just different place.
We had to walk across a rickety old bridge to get into Costa Rica, where another minivan took us to the small town of Puerto Viejo, where we stayed for a couple of nights. It was another chilled out place where we didn't get up to much, but unlike San Blas and Bocas, it wasn't chilled out because of its natural vibe, it's just that everyone was fucking high. So we quickly headed northwest, up into the mountains to La Fortuna, which lies beside the Arenal volcano.
So we're now in La Fortuna. Tons of stuff to do here, like whitewater rafting, bungee jumping, zip lining, and going up the massive volcano, but we've done all that already. So because our time was cut short on the Amazon, we're gonna go see some more wildlife in a park called Caño Negro. But for now, we're just chilling by the pool before the afternoon tropical storm kicks in. Phase two of the weather cycle, the rain has started. 1 o'clock, so a little bit earlier than usual. This is when we move from a swimming pool. Not that way. So we move from a swimming pool. Oh, it is that way. This is how I do it. It's when we move from the swimming pool to the bar. Explain what I just did.
I just had one beer left. So Karl kindly offered to go and get beers while the rain stopped and the thunderstorm. And lucky me.
Yeah. But basically, I wish my camera's waterproof because the whole street is just a river. And yeah, I'm soaked to the bone. But we got the beer, so that's all that is.
Late night nature trail, James Walsh.
I'm just finding all the animals. Always.
Just gotta try and capture it. That's...
You got it? I don't want to fucking hurt it. There you go, that is the end of James's wildlife tour.
It was just over an hour's drive to the Caño Negro Wildlife Refuge. And on the way, we stopped at a cafe where there was a few iguanas hanging out in the bushes.
Clever girl.
Continuing your tradition of trying to pick up animals.
Yeah,
there we go.
James, I thought you got that
out of your
system.
Oh, he's moving.
He's got quite a little grid on his face.
He's hung over like you.
Yeah, I'm talking about you.
He's definitely eyeballing me now. What? Yeah, I didn't go to bed. I didn't have any sleep. Problem.
Once we reached Caño Negro, we boarded the boat that would take us on a 2-hour tour through the wildlife refuge.
We need to keep the balance in the boat. That means if we see something in this side of the boat, please, please, not everybody move to this part, okay? We stay there, we move the boat, okay? Okay?
Yeah. The common basilisk here is known as the Jesus Christ lizard for its ability to run on the surface of water.
There we go, there we go. There we go. There we go. There we go.
the lizards are so scared from the white-faced monkey. White-faced monkey kill iguanas, kill lizards, kill snakes, everything, right?
Stop being so brave. Run away. There we go. Got it.
How about you there?
Yeah. Monkey to the left. Loads of them in the tree.
Up there.
I see it.
He's sitting right in the middle of that mural, like, they are howler monkeys.
Finally got to see the howler monkeys that were making all the noise in Brazil.
Could be monkeys.
They're basically just there, it's just we can't see them, but...
It turns out the howler monkey is the second loudest mammal in the world, beaten only by the blue whale.
That orange color on the monkey, you only see it in this area, Costa Rica.
Further down the river, we saw more of the white-faced monkeys that have been going after the Jesus Christ lizards.
They have prehensile tail. What it means, they can use it as an extra arm. In Costa Rica, three monkeys use their tail in that way. Howlers, spider monkeys, and ones we already saw, white-faced.
He's got a little baby on his back as well. We got bats. What kind of bats are they?
Long nose bats.
In this branch, you see the green point up there?
Oh yeah. Okay.
You see like a line of black spots.
It looks like part of the bark.
It's a bark. Well, they are just sleeping up there, you know.
So hanging loose, stay, chilling.
Waiting for the night time.
They had a heavy night out, so they're just chilling.
One thing we really didn't expect to see in the jungle was some deer.
My first time to see these guys here. First time. 5 years, first time. 11 years, maybe.
It just feels weird seeing them in the jungle, doesn't it?
Right side, there is a caiman. You follow the bank down to the left. Can you see it from there? Everybody can see all of them there atrás.
Right here.
It looks so real, right?
How did you guys spot him? Like, how did you see him?
Good question.
Not easy. I mean, when I came here first time, I say, wow, how did you guys find this? You know? But it just with the time, you learn where you can find so many ones. You see the different. You see a tree, and then you see something different, right? Yeah. It's our office.
Yes.
You know?
And the lower branches on the right side there, and that big tree.
Third monkey today, spider monkey.
Thank you, monkey. The one is inside there is a male. The right side of the baby is a male. The bigger one there, I think it's the alpha, the leader of the group.
Wow. The baby's right above it.
After seeing so many different animals, our trip to Canyon Negro certainly helped make up for our time being cut short in the Amazon. And the animal spotting even continued on the journey back.
We got ourselves a slot for the journey home.
Talking about.
Who spotted him?
You spotted him?
Ah, driver spotted him.
A couple of days later, we were heading up to our third country of this leg, Nicaragua.
When we arrived here, we took the shuttle, which is pretty much the easy way of doing it. But today, we're going by public transport, which means we have to use all of our amazing Spanish, and hopefully it'll work out all right.
Yeah, this is it.
Now, going to Nicaragua was never part of the plan for Central America. We were just going to do Panama and Costa Rica. But ever since we arrived, everyone said we had to head up here, because not only is it way cheaper, there's also a massive party we shouldn't miss out on called the Sunday Funday Pool Crawl. Crossing the border took over an hour. There was the usual bullshit of filling out forms and people trying to scam you.
James' favorite pastime? Immigration form?
Yeah. Like damn what they already can meet.
Plus Pete, who was making the same journey as us, he tried to scam him out of $100 just because his passport was wet.
Made it, man.
Made it.
Well, we made it here. I'm just gonna basically get fucked for 4 days. With the climax being Sunday Funday Pool Crawl on Sunday, which should be awesome. But this is the view from our room.
Good decision to come to Nicaragua, eh?
Oh yeah, man. I'm having a great time. Look at these colors.
I'm just saying, we live such a stressful life.
Ours in the bowl?
I know, it's like ounces.
We are continuing James's round the world nature documentary series. He's found a fish, but can you catch it though? Can you catch it? Fuck, you got it.
I think it needs to be clean because there's too much sand on it.
No, it's just covered in here.
He'd probably get drunk if he wasn't dead.
I'm gonna name this the James fish.
Because he's drunk and nearly dead.
That now has two eyes.
I know, like, what that is, but...
I'm going on someone.
But, like...
You walked into that one.
Yeah, a little like that.
Oh! Saliva! Toy trick! Rub its back. Comes back to life. When you rub its back, it comes back to life.
What are you trying to sell him here?
Yeah.
Give him a kiss. Where he starts forming the heart to show his love for James.
Tea, you got tea now?
It's beautiful.
You've got a
heart, I've got a flower, and I've got an arrow through my heart.
Because that kid broke your heart.
Small boy broke my heart.
Give him a hug. A hug.
I have to say though, that guy's rapping, phenomenal. I need to get this shit on YouTube right away. Yes. That was amazing.
Boom. He broke my heart.
He broke my heart.
It's full on like Siberia's.
It's Friday night. Boom.
And I'm from LA.
Feeling all right. Boom. Peace. That's what it was.
After 3 days of just hanging out and drinking together, the Sunday Funday Pool Crawl was finally upon us.
Pumped and ready for Sunday Funday?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man. You guys enjoying Sunday Funday?
Yeah, baby!
They're from America, by the way.
Hey, yeah.
See the injury?
My injury. I don't have any. So I dived in. Such a good dive. I face planted at the bottom of the pool.
Good work. Good work. We have free shots of Malibu through ice. You guys ready? You excited? All this time
I was finding myself. More. Mas. Uno mas.
We're on to the next bar, the next pool, which I think is our pool. Alright, we're at bar number two, which is back at our hostel, Naked Tiger. You guys have a good time with Naked Tiger?
Fucking right!
As with most big nights out, it all becomes a bit of a blur after a while. But as far as I can remember, we had an amazing time. The next day, we took a bus down to San Jose to catch our flight for our last leg, driving across America. We don't know what the backpacker scene is going to be like in the States, or if it exists at all, so our time in Central America was really just about experiencing one last big backpacking party, enjoying lots of cheap beer with good people in the tropical sun. And then, we'll wait and see what America holds for us.
Now we're driving from LA to New York.
So exciting!
Winner at the Mirage.
Actually the least crowded I've ever seen it, which is quite nice. Move the seat back and, we're in Roswell.
Culture of Niagara Falls, eh? So I think this is as fast as the car will go.
Super size. Yeah. We got pulled over by the police for speeding.
And remember, this is miles per hour, not kilometers.